Hey guys, and welcome back to Pokemon White 2 walkthrough, or Let's Play Take Your Pick. I did start streaming a second ago, but the stream actually cut out, and I had to reset my connection. So yeah, we're just going to carry on from where we left off. Now last time, if you guys remember, we spent a lot of time getting Eevee and training a little bit, just to kind of bring ourselves up to speed. But yeah, now we're back on track now, and we are ready to go, and we are ready to move on towards the fourth gym. And actually, guys, in this route, we should be getting another couple of our team members together. There's actually two Pokemon in here that I actually want to catch, and I'll actually finish off our team. And it doesn't seem like, it doesn't seem long ago since we actually started the game. And we'll already almost have our whole team sorted. So yeah, that's actually really awesome. And yeah, so let's get going. And he's gonna open up with a Sandile. And Sandile, guys, is really no threat to anyone. And we can easily take him out. Especially, I didn't even mean to use Bug Bite, but I still think Bug Bite will actually still do quite a bit of damage. Yeah, there we go, still KOs at one shot. And Morphs 2 is going to get a little bit of experience, because I put the XP share on him. And we're going to go into Thunders for this. But, as I said before, guys, I will not actually be using Morphs 2 until it evolves into Vaporeon. Purely for the fact, Eevee's mediocre at best. It hasn't really got anything outstanding going for it. So, really, it's going to be a hard time until it eventually evolves. Or its presence is just going to kind of be there. Be there in case I need to switch into something, or, you know the drill. And there we go. A little bit of experience in them both. But as I said, I will actually be catching two Pokemon in this route. So yeah, it'll be really awesome. And the two Pokemon we catch, I wonder if anyone knows what I'll be getting. And here we go, Drillbur versus Bugsy. Drillbur is a great Pokemon, guys. If you've not used a Drillbur and evolved into an Excadrill, I can definitely recommend you go ahead and do that. I actually used one on my first ever Pokemon. What game was it? It was Black 2 I used, my Pokemon Black 2 playthrough. And definitely was a great support on my team. Zero complaints. And there we go, Marill's just going to drop down, and we are going to just like say goodnight, and we're going to move on. And here we go, so let's have a little look down here. There's a couple of fishermen down here. I can probably get Thunder a little bit of experience. And that's really the whole idea we're trying to get here. We want to level up a little bit. But this route is full of trainers. There's nothing really too challenging. We're all about level 16, so the fact that we leveled up in our last episode to about 21, we're nice. We're back on track, is what I'm trying to say. Because when we actually fought Bruff in the last gym, we were kind of under-leveled, and then we kind of over-leveled, what'd you call him? Was it Fire Bacon? Yeah, what'd you call him? Yeah, Fire Bacon. So Fire Bacon ended up getting over-leveled, while everything else ended up lagging behind slightly. So the fact that we're all kind of back on track now is kind of a really good sign. But the next gym's actually an electric gym, and I kind of figured, look, I haven't actually got anything that's kind of... it's gonna really help me out that much. So I kinda figured I will catch a Pokemon in this route that will help me out, and you know what, it's a good Pokemon, so I might as well keep it on my team. And you know, that's just gonna find it in a couple of minutes. But there you go, that's a Mystic Water right there. And the Mystic Water is really helpful because it will actually boost the attack damage of water types by 20% when they use water moves. So that can be really helpful, especially against gym leaders in tough battles. But you know, it's kind of all up to you if you want to put it on your Pokemon or not, but I would recommend doing that, and I will be doing that as soon as I get a Vaporeon. And there we go. And we will climb off, we'll dismounting our ride here. And we will be having a look around in the sand. Anytime today. There we go. Wait, what? I didn't even know you found them here. Alright, well apparently you can actually get Mankana? I don't know. Apparently you can actually find them here, so if you want one of them, go ahead. I don't really recommend them myself, but... here's another great Pokemon, Darmanica, or however you want to pronounce it. A great Pokemon to have in any team, really helpful, evolves into a really good fire type. So if you want one of them, go ahead. But here's what we were looking for. Now, I'll actually be having a Sandile on my team. The reason for this, it's a ground type, and it's a dark type. Not a lot more needs to be said, it's, you know, really high attack. I'll be really happy with it on my team. But, so yeah. And, where's the Pokeball? One wiggle, two wiggles, three wiggles, and there we go. See, why couldn't Morphs have been like Sandile? Like, he just wanted to join my team. He was just, you know, he was dead set on it. And he's a desert frog. And what we'll call him. We'll be calling him Baby Jaws. There we go. Baby Jaws. And then when he eventually evolves, he'll become Daddy Jaws. I'll actually go out of my way to find the name later. And let's just quickly heal up. And the XP share is actually going to be getting taken off Morphs now, and it'll be getting put onto Sandile, or Baby Jaws. And where is it? We'll be finding item, give. XP share, there we go. And now we are actually ready to move on and take out this guy up here. Or maybe we don't actually have to fight him. I've been waiting for you, what's the matter? Interesting, what's behind me? He's under the rocks, but we're to observe this device that'll create energy. Okay, so he's just gonna move him out of the way for you. So it kind of reminds me of Kecleon used to get in your way in Ruby and Sapphire. Okay, so is he gonna try and fight us? Yep, so yeah, okay, there you go. Okay, well, game on. And he's gonna open out of his Magnemite. And it's trainers like this, guys, that are gonna actually be quite difficult for us in the next kinda area, which is why I'm actually another main reason for getting big jaws. Or baby jaws. Because electric types are actually, we're not gonna kill anything on my team particularly easily. But there's nothing really on my own team that can kinda that was particularly good for taking them out, so for that reason only, we've now got baby jaws. Although obviously I'll need to level up a little bit before we get to the next city and the gym. But yeah, it should be all good. Come on, we can do this. We have got this. Ah, oh, jeez, paralyzed. Buffed by the sandstorm. I don't think he's been hit by paralyzation or paralysis once. God damn it. You know what? Fuck you. Baby Jaws, you have got this. I should probably heal you. Oh wait, shit, he's using a super potion as well? Really? Really? What moves do you actually have, Baby Jaws? Actually, I have Sand Tomb. Let's go, Baby Jaws, we have got this. You can do this. Oh god, Baby Jaws, you actually could do this. Or maybe not. Don't kill me. Oh, come on, Baby Jaws, we have got this. This will be your first ever debut. No. Yes. Perfect. No, do not die on me, Baby Jaws. Baby Jaws, do not die. Come on, Santum, hit. Do not avoid. Yes. Awesome, Baby Jaws. Brilliant.
Oh, Moxie. Nice, I didn't even check with nature or anything I actually got. The fact it's Moxie, I'm happy anyway. Let's have a look at the stats anyway. Okay, so he's gonna go into Clink, and I probably should switch, to be honest, but I'm feeling kind of ballsy. And I've got one Moxie, so providing this doesn't absolutely kill... Yeah, there we go. Okay, it killed me. Okay, feeling ballsy doesn't work, guys. Okay, Fire Bacon, you've got this. I didn't want to use it, because Fire Bacon will just sweep him. But, I'm not really complaining. Fire Bacon's got this quite easily, so Fire Bacon has this down. And he'll also get the speed boost. Nobody really needs it, because steel types are particularly slow. And I see, just like the gym leaders in each year, if we had 4 champion, you would bring out the power in Pokemon. Yeah, oh shucks. Now I can't remember, is there actually a place I can heal around here? I don't think there is, because I'm going to quickly run all the way back and heal, or I'm going to cycle, I'm not going to run. Who runs? Well, not in Pokemon anyway. See, this would be that moment where I wish I had Fly. But, you know, seeing as we're doing this whole game from scratch, and Sam, Samamo2332 This is actually Pokemon White 2. So yeah, this is the remake that was released, not the remake, the sequel that was released kind of late last year. So yeah, I'm trying to basically fire through as much of it today as possible, so... Oh, so... Alright, that's really cool. Is that the original Black 1 that you're playing, or as in, like, you're playing Black 2 as in you're playing Black 2 as in TWO? Alright, that's really cool. So you're playing the opposite version then. That's pretty cool. How far into the game are you? And we're just going to cycle all the way back up. Now that we've fully healed, Baby Jaws is back on track, and... what do you call him is back as well, so... Thunder, that's it. Actually, you're not actually that much further. That's pretty cool. Although Clay's a bitch, isn't he, really? I'm actually thinking I might have a little bit of trouble with Clay. Wait, what? Why have I got to fight this now? Oh, okay. Oh yeah, there's certain trainers in this game, guys, that you'll actually have to fight every single time you go past them. And this is one of them. Ah, so Clay probably wouldn't have been much trouble then. See, I ended up going with, Tepig, so... It shouldn't be too much more difficult, but because I have a grass type for the other two Pokemon in this team, is just kind of going to be the Excadrill. To be honest, Clay's the only gym I'm kind of, I wouldn't say worried about, just kind of, pardon me, a little bit more apprehensive to do. And Baby Jaws is going to get a nice bit. Oh, thanks, Samo. See you later. I wouldn't say I'm concerned. I don't really know. I'd say I'm a bit more at... As I said, a little bit more apprehensive. It's like, I feel that I can do Clay quite, not easily, but... I feel that he'll be a bit more of a challenge than the other gym leaders have been so far. It probably shouldn't be too difficult though, right? It'll just be kinda... I feel that Clay will be the more difficult one out of the ones we've done so far. Or up to this point. What's this guy saying to it? Desert Resort just passed here. I'm not really interested in them, so no, go away. Okay, so we're going to have a double battle here. I think this is actually our first actual double battle in this game. So that's going to be quite cool. And who we got out front? We've got Thunder and Bugsy. He's going to quick attack one and bug bite the other. But nah, Leavanny's definitely a major powerhouse in my team at the moment. Leavanny's definitely, you know, probably my best Pokemon, to be honest, at this point. Just look at that attack. And everyone's gonna get buffed. There we go. And it was a good game, Twins, but we're just not quite there yet. No, ruin.
It's a good game, but no cigar. Oh! I didn't even see that person. I didn't even think I was a trainer. You there, I've become bored. I shall let you entertain me. You will let me entertain you. Never realized you were Robbie Williams. Or I was Robbie Williams. Okay, so this is Leopard. This is a dark type in itself, and it's the evolution of Purloin. I think this is the first time we've seen one, so... It won't be difficult, but it'll be a bit interesting. And that's really all they'll do at first, is they'll always make you flinch. And it is extremely annoying. Oh, I can't use the same move twice, okay, so I'm gonna use Shockwave. So close. So close, but yet so far. Oh, jeez, okay. Oh, killed by the sandstorm. And Baby Jaws is going to grow up to 17. And I'm going to use a super potion. Super potion, there you are. There we go, we are back on track, we are ready to go, and nothing can stop us now. Hopefully, anyway. Come here. God damn it, oh god damn it, come here! Come back and fight me! Okay, can't even see this, it's behind a building. This is cheap. And we're against Backpacker Rachel, and she's going to open out with Woobat. And this is a nice, easy kill for Thunder. Let's probably get a Shockwave off on it, and then hopefully it'll one-hit KO it. Oh, seriously? Okay. Yeah, that's cool. Seems legit. Finish it off a quick attack. And Baby Jaws has grown to 18. So Baby Jaws is quickly catching up. And Pidove, prepare to go down. There we go. Night night, Pidove. All the way around here. It's down here. What's this guy after? What's this guy? What's this guy's game at? What's he playing at? Please check out my Pokemon. Well, I guess seeing as you said please, I guess I will. And he's gonna go open up and he's gonna open up with a Growlithe, level 21. So it's not that threatening, but it's, you know, it's not gonna be. It's not the most difficult fight, but it's not the easiest fight. And the easiest fight would be a Magikarp, let's be serious. Fire Fang. Oh jeez. Was I saying that about that not being a challenging fight, really? There we go. Growlithe's gone down. And he's gonna level up as well, so that's gonna be pretty awesome for us. And going into Sandshrew, so we're going to be going into Bugsy. Or Bugsy Female. No, not Bug Bite. God damn it, I meant to use Razor Leaf. I'll say that's the one thing about Pokemon games, is sitting when you mash the A button. And there we go, Sandshrew, good game, but not quite good enough for you. Mud Slap. No, I don't really want to learn Mud Slap. Okay, so I've got to go all the way around there then. Okay, that's cool. Can I get down that little alley? No. Okay, so there was no point in me whatsoever coming down there except for that trainer. No hidden items, no. Nothing. Whoa, the f- Woo! I see. I believe, that looks interesting.
Yeah, it is normally on a Monday, but because I'm not gonna sit and wait around until a Monday, I changed my clock settings. So yeah, that, not necessarily cheating, but kind of speeding up the process. Because I wasn't gonna wait until Monday to get a flying type, if you know what I mean. But I didn't actually know that's where it was. I actually thought it was down where I went before. Hence why I was kind of looking about. I was just like, okay, it's not here. Confused. God damn it, Thunder. You've let me down. Oh wait, okay, so... Not really complaining. Baby Jaws is going to get all the experience. No. This is going to be the intense moment of us getting our final team member already. Although... I don't know. It's going to be quite... I might come back at the end, or in a bit, and come and get it. I'm going to hold it off just now. Purely in the fact that... Thunder did just get knocked out, and I do want to paralyze it just to kind of get that extra chance of capture, so I'm gonna basically go about, try and find the nurse, heal up, and then from that moment I'll come straight back and then we'll go and catch it, because I'm pretty sure it is actually quite difficult to catch. And Herdier, as I said before guys, Herdier is actually a tank of a Pokemon, really high attack, so they can be quite threatening at this point in the game, especially if you're not using a fighting type. Although if you do want a fighting type, a really good fighting type that you can catch is Scraggy, and that is actually in this desert area you're in right now, so if you have a wee look about in the sand, it's a really good fighting type. I can definitely recommend you go and catch it. Especially if you're looking for a fighting type in your team. So yeah, I can recommend that. So this is this house here. I feel like just walking into this house here. No, I don't want to hear you mimic a sound. What do you take me for? Okay, so we will carry on north. Okay, so that's actually the route onwards, so we're not really wanting to go up there yet. Okay, there's a backpacker here we can battle. But no, if you go on up that way, then you'll actually move on to the next city, and we don't actually want to go up there yet. And he's going to open up with Ryolu. And as I said before guys, Ryolu is a really good Pokemon. If you've gone and caught one, that's a really cool idea. Obviously I didn't, so... Copycat. Well, that's gonna do absolutely nothing. I can just tell, it's gonna do like under 10. Yeah, did like 2 HP.
And good gamer all of you, but nope, not good enough. No cigar. And he's gonna go into Timber, who's a pure fighting type, but it's a pretty good Pokemon. Evolves into a absolute beast of a tank, Clonk-Clonk-Clonk-Clonk. So yeah, really good Pokemon, but you know, as a Timber, there's not much you can do. And Baby Jaws is actually nicely caught up now. He's level 20. Really, we don't need DXP share on him too much longer. And if you come up over this way, it takes you to the Desert Resort. And the Desert Resort is basically a place full of tough trainers. That's really, and some cool items on the ground as well. And this is the main reason we were coming to the Desert Resort. And she's gonna really have a Clefairy? Okay. I'm not here to pass judgment on your Pokemon team. It avoided the attack. Haha, double avoid. And we're gonna Razor Leaf, and Clefa will hopefully go down in 2 hits. Oh! Okay. Nice one. And there we go, guys. And I think it's actually the first nurse we've found in this game. And in case you didn't already know, if you actually come to the nurses, they will actually heal you up, so really good idea to do that. And morphs to, you can come down back here. There we go. I will show you the harshness of the desert through battle. Okay, let's... unless you can use Sandstorm, I don't really care. Go away. Okay, so I've gone into Bugsy. Probably not a good move. And you know what, I'm actually gonna switch into Baby Jaws. And Vasquez Ground's actually gonna be super effective against fire, so... Oh, and I actually avoided his attack. And I never actually understood that. Does Darmaraka not actually live in the desert, yet it still gets buffeted by the sandstorm? And I actually will admit... wait, what? Okay, fuck. Okay, we're gonna go into Thunder. Looks like Thunder's gonna get a kill. As I was saying, Darmaraka actually lives in the desert, yet it still gets buffeted by the sandstorm. I always kind of figured that was kind of, not pointless, but it was just kind of... It didn't really make sense, if you know what I mean. It was kind of... It just doesn't actually seem to flow. In fact, a Pokemon would live in the desert, yet it still gets hurt by the sandstorm. So... I don't know. I always thought it was a bit of a logic flaw, but you know. I always think we should have excluded Darmaraka and Dartamatan from that rule, but you know. And if you actually, in certain areas, certain Pokemon will appear that used to belong to Trainer N. And I actually remember the first time this happened, I didn't actually realize, and I was just like, wait, that's not a shiny, why did a little spiral thing come around it? And it was just kind of like, I ended up killing it. Yeah, no, I realized that basically, apparently, anytime a Pokemon does that, it's actually used to belong to Trainer N. And actually, where we are right now is the first time that ever happens, so, well, for me anyway. I think it was his Darnamitan. And it was like level 35, and I was like, whoa. I thought I'd like come across some major rare Pokemon, so. Come on, keep Razor Leafing. We have got this. Oh, seriously, you avoided it? Okay, so we should get the kill this time if he doesn't avoid it again. There we go. Dweble is actually a really cool Pokemon. It evolves into, I can't remember the name of it, but it's like the big sand thing we just seen not long ago. And, I don't know, I always quite liked it. I thought it was always a good Pokemon, but... Okay, so what's this wifey saying to it? Backpacker Tammy. And she's gonna send out a Drillbur. But Drillbur is no match for Bugsy. And hopefully one Razor Leaf will take this out. I have faith, and faith pays off. I don't have faith. I don't trust you, Bugsy, at all. And Big Jaws is still kinda holding the XP share, slowly trojaning on behind. What's this? Max either. Slowly walk up the back here. And if you actually remember from Black and White 1, there used to be like a massive tower here, and it's now actually just covered in sand. And oh jeez, what's this? She's gonna come out as like a massive ghost team, I can just tell. Not if she's dressed like a psychic or anything. Oh, and it's a Muna. I actually think this is the first Muna we have encountered as well. And Muna is actually a psychic type purely. And I always think the evolution looks like a fetus. But you know. It's a pretty good psychic type, so if you ever come across one, feel like using it, you know, might as well. But again, it's no match for Bugsy. The funnest new shit added to it. Okay, so apparently I've got like an extra little thing to do now, but I'm not going to do that at some point. Or anytime soon. Okay, this guy's just talking shit. Come here, goddammit, backpacker. And here we go. And as I said, guys, this route is just really good training. It's nothing really challenging, but it's just kinda... You're likely to get up a good few levels from doing it. And where the hell's my foot? There it is. I had to check the time as I've actually changed the clock settings on my laptop. There we go. Anything up here? Yep, there is. A heart scale. And heart scales are obviously really good items, guys, so if you can see them, pick them up. And we've got another psychic here, who's just like, I don't know, all the psychics just seem to hang about. He's kind of a lawyer. Psychic Tommy. Sounds like a bad psychic show, doesn't it, really? Psychic Tommy's come to town. And, I'm gonna switch into Thunder for this guy. And I think it's time we almost took, the XP share off of, Baby Jaws. As I think Baby Jaws is kinda caught up in levels. And there goes Woobat. Woobat's dead already, so that's good for us. And going into Yamask. And I'm gonna actually send Baby Jaws out for this, just to kinda get the damage bonus from Dark type onto Ghost, so. Actually, is it a Ghost or is it a Psychic? Either way. Oh god damn it, I lost my Moxie. Will-O-Wisp, eh? Yeah, so Will-O-Wisp will actually burn you, and when you actually become burned, your attack will actually get halved, so... Burn can actually be really annoying, especially if you have physical attacking Pokemon. Wild Pokemon. Go away, Dwebble. I'm actually gonna throw up a repel in a second. Kinda actually forgot. Okay, so a repel is now going up. Repel. I only have 3 left, oh jeez. This is getting some dangerous territory. What's this guy doing? I will give you this, the Soft Sand. And the Soft Sand will actually increase ground-type moves, so... Really useful, especially if you've just caught yourself Sandile. So that can be really useful. And what's this Ranger talking about? What's she going with? She's going with Magby. And again, I'm going in with Bugsy, and it's kind of a bad move. So we're going... Baby Jaws is poisoned. Not poisoned. Burned. So his attack will actually be halved, so there's not a lot of point going in with him. Flame... Oh, jeez. I think Magby actually will kill me. But I want to just weaken him down so the Baby Jaws can get the kill. Baby Jaws, can you do it? I have faith, Baby Jaws, you've got this. And I reckon I'll probably take 2 hits to kill it. Oh, jeez. Baby Jaws, maybe I had too much faith in you. Is it gonna die? Nope. Although, if I... Heal up, Baby Jaws. Then it'll attack. And it should still get hurt. There we go. And Baby Jaws has grown to 22. And what's the one in Margo? Nope. There we go, so... 22 Baby Jaws. And really, that's pretty much all my team caught up, except for Morphs, which is still kind of lagging back at 20, but as I said, Morphs won't actually really be getting used until we actually get a Water Stone and just can evolve it straight away. because when we get the water stone, we should get surf not long after, so... where are we going? Up and around, here we go. I think there's just a couple more trainers in here. There's actually a couple of trainers. Oh, seriously? Ah, Christ. So yeah, you can actually fall through those, and when you do, there's not even a point struggling, you're just gonna fall, so just let yourself go down. And I think there's only, I think these are the last two trainers we have to fight, and then we've kind of done this whole route. And then I reckon we'll go back, get Bravery onto our team, and then we should move on to the next city. And even though I catch Bravery, I probably won't use it right away. I'll probably just kind of have it with me. So I might even just deposit it in the PC so I'm not tempted. And that's because I don't want to have like 6 Pokemon with me by like the 4th gym. There we go. Just because it's quite a lot to train. And here we go, Psychic Parry. And it's a Psychic Flying type. So Bug moves won't actually be very effective against it, and... So I'm going to go in with, what do you call him again? Thunder. Either Thunder or Baby Jaws could probably handle this, but I think Thunder kind of... kind of needs to redeem himself, and plus he'll evolve at level 30, so... The sooner I get him up to more levels, the better. I might actually go and do some off-screen training at the end of this episode, just to kind of level everyone up a little bit. But yeah, everything seems to be going really well so far. Everything's kind of going smoothly. Come on, skill scope, die. Oh, critical hit, and just survived. Sit down. But they are actually really good Pokemon, so if you want to get one of them as well, on you go, I wouldn't stop you. Well, I can't stop you anyway, what you get, but I wouldn't not recommend them. I think they just get a little bit repetitive. And we're run, there we go. And we're going to heal up at the nurse. And then we're going to head back, and we are now going to go back and capture Bravery. And he will join our team. I get that feeling he will be... I get the feeling he's going to be a pain in the ass to capture, though. I think it's going to be quite a difficult catch. I'm pretty sure that house used to have digging it. Oh, an item room there. Oh! Speaking of dig. And I'm actually going to quickly teach that to Sandile. Let's cut, I don't want to teach that. My number. And that's convenient. Baby Jaws, you will learn Dig. And you shall enjoy it. But yeah, now Baby Jaws, learning Dig's definitely a good move. Especially for the gym coming up. What other teams do I actually have? I haven't got bad stuff actually. I reckon I'll teach Strength. I think I'll teach it to Baby Jaws when it evolves. And And I'm actually going to quickly switch Dig to the top. That's going to be the main move I use. And here we go, guys. We are ready to take on that Bravery. And it's going to be... I get a feeling it'll be quite annoying to catch, but I think we can do it. I think I have faith. Rah, 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 rah.
Okay, Bravery. Prepare to be captured. And it's level 25, so... decent leveled Pokemon. But the fact that it is sandstorming as well won't really do me any favors, because it will actually slightly get weakened every time. So when I actually bring it down to the red zone, there's a limit to the amount of amount of times that I can actually keep it going. So it's going to be quite a difficult fight. And even I don't even have faith it's going to live one shockwave. Like, I don't know, I'm sure, I think it would, but I'm just going to sit and quick attack spam it. And I think I'm going to start throwing balls at it when it gets down to the red. Or not the red, the orange. And there we go, so... come on, Bravery. You know you want to join the squad. Not even a wiggle. Christ. That was disappointing, to say the least. Come on. Join the squad, Bravery. I don't want this to be a repeat of what happened with Eevee. Especially the fact I'm on a time schedule to catch you. One wiggle, two wiggles, three wiggles! Christ, Bravery, you're on my team. I'm very happy now. I'm actually surprised that was so easy. Or not easy, but I'm surprised it caught so quickly. I don't have a nickname, so if there's any nicknames, just fire them out into the chat quickly. What should we call him? I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna just call him. I'm gonna call him Bilbo. I don't really know why. Just gonna call him Bilbo. Even though does Bilbo have two L's in it? If so, I've just misspelt his name. Ah, well. Bilbo, let's have a look at you. It's a docile nature. Doesn't make a difference, just kinda indifferent. When its stats are lowered, its attack increases. So, probably the better ability. I can't remember what the other one is anyway. But yeah, no, I'm quite happy with that, so... welcome to the team, Bilbo. But onwards to Mordor, now that we have Bilbo. Did I take the XP share off with Baby Jaws? No, I didn't. And there we go. You're now ready to move on and keep going up. And up. What the hell is this? Oh, jeez. I don't even want to see... no! If I try and avoid you and go around you, it means I don't want to have the conversation. It's going to be absolutely 20 pages long in dialogue and amount to nothing that I want to do. This guy doesn't even have any eyes. What did I agree to do? What am I doing? What's my favorite phrase? I haven't got a phrase. I'm just gonna say no. No. The words you are about to enter may be sent to other players. Please consider them carefully. I don't want to do this. God damn it, leave me alone.
Ugh. Why must people in Pokemon games force me to do things I don't want to do? God damn it. Pleased to meet you. Oh, okay. What? This is a nickname in the avenue only. A.
Okay, so we can finally move on. Can I ride my bike in here?
I can. Well, at least that's something good. Okay, so that's in Nimbasa City now. The city of the electric gym. And, yeah, I actually really like Nimbasa. Kind of reminds me of Mustafa, you know, Lion King. No. Anyway, I'm just gonna quickly deposit him down, and I'm gonna heal up. I don't really think I need to too much, to be honest, but it'd just be nice to do it. And there we go. Hope to see you again. And I'm gonna get some potions, cause I need potions, really. Oh, we can get revives here as well. 20 super potions, I think. I'm gonna get a handful of revives. Just revives are really handy. They bring a Pokemon that's been fainted, back to fighting form, I guess. I don't know. Battle Institute. Ooh. What's this about? No matter which way I look at it, you're a trainer, but only the strong can enter. So if you beat the champion, come back. Okay, so all of them have clearly beat the champion then. Doubt it. I doubt any of them beat the champion, to be honest. Okay, you're not saying anything interesting. Anything interesting over here? Nope. Anything interesting you guys say? Nope, didn't think so. What about you, old lady? Oh, okay, she wants to give me the Sue Bell. Okay, so, that's not bad. At least I got some free stuff there. And we can now leave this bit here, I hope. What's in this house here, actually? I always like looking around. I don't think I've actually done it that much so far in this walkthrough, but I'm actually going to start looking around places more now. When I say looking about, I mean, I'm just going to quickly try and get a bunch of Sunstone. Okay, so Sunstone's pretty good. But, nothing really valuable that we need in there. Anything going on over here? Just the free stadiums. What are you saying to it? Oh, I don't want to talk to you twice. A roller coaster reminds me of the move Quick Attack. If you say so. And if you actually come over here, you will actually see the old gym. And in the old gym is actually still some trainers that actually will remain. So yeah, it's always a cool thing to do. And if you actually come over here, there's some random wifey here that's like, do you want to battle me? And you're just like, yeah. And if you actually, this is actually the Ferris wheel that you ride with N in the first one, so I think if you actually kill her, she'll actually ride it with you. So I'm guessing that's your incentive of the game, so. Okay, we're gonna go into Baby Jaws. Just cause Baby Jaws is gonna start needing some practice taking out these electric types. And I actually should have thought about that before I entered this battle, but you know. Flaffy's just gonna sit and spam charge. Okay, that's his choice really. Electric attacks aren't gonna be anything to me anyway, so. Like, why did you use charge again? Seriously? It's not gonna do anything. Okay. You know what? Whatever. It's gonna assurance you to death. No. God damn it. It's cool, Moxie's activated, although I'm pretty sure that was our only Pokemon, so it's not even worth it. Although we did get a decent amount of experience, so you want to ride the Ferris? No, I don't. Okay, so now you get to ride the Ferris wheel with this beauty, apparently, so I guess that was the whole reasoning behind it. I wonder if other people look at us and think we're a couple. Well, we are, really, aren't we? I mean, look at us. So beautiful and tranquil. Don't move from that spot, be still. Just like that. Huh. Bit rude. Looking out the window seems dangerous, just looks straight at me. I'm confused. Am I a couple with you now? Huh. Okay then. If you weren't such an honest person, that might have been your end. Straight, didn't even give me anything free for going on it with you. I don't paralyze you like I do. And Baby Jaws, you are now fully healed from your paralysis. And I'm going to actually move Baby Jaws up front. Which Baby Jaws will probably get a few levels just by fighting off the electric types. And this is actually the new gym right here. What's he saying? The gym leader is out right now. Okay, so you can't even do the gym right now. I think you actually have to do the old gym first, I think. And I'm pretty sure actually if you keep on going through it, at the end of it, the gym leader's little sister's in here. But I don't actually remember, so. Okay, you're not even gonna battle me. That's disappointing. You battle me? Nope. Come on, hurry up. Where are you? Uh-huh. No, 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 I'm gonna miss it! No. Wait. Oh, so you battle me. Maybe Barrett battle me. Anyway, you just made me miss my ride. And this is a rich boy, Roland. And rich boys will actually give you loads of money if you kill them, so... Let's kill this Blitzel and be done with it. Baby Jaws will go dig. And I think Baby Jaws will probably kill this in either one or two hits, so... There we go, Blitzel's gone down. And Moxie's been activated, but I think... So we're kind of a waste again, because I think that's his only Pokemon. I've got style. I know I do. Anytime today, dude. Anytime. There we go. Come on, here we go. Oh, we've got to go the whole long way, don't we? Okay. And I think another trainer will actually jump out at you here. Yep. You should probably have something else, like a useless Pokemon as well. Not useless, but just... not really gonna cause much of a threat to me. It's gonna be another Flaffy. And Baby Jaws is gonna bury underground. And hit it with dig. And there we go, one hit KO'd. Although I did get paralyzed by it, so... I guess it's kinda bringing its vengeance on. Yep, I'm such a horrible person, haven't I? Oh, loop-de-loop. And here we go, one last trainer. Oh, she's gonna give us a paralyzed heal. Or maybe she's not even a trainer. Yeah, she's not. She's not even a trainer. Okay, so... That's just basically gone through this bit now. It was only two trainers, it wasn't really worth it, we just had to go about. I think we just had to wait for the gym leader to return. So hopefully this guy will move. Yeah, so we could actually go and do the gym now. Although I think I am seriously underleveled. And I think if I was to go and do the gym right now, I would get smoked in a second. I'm gonna go for musical theater. What's this? I think this is a football stadium. And there's actually a couple of trainers down here you can battle, so I recommend you go ahead and go and just quickly do them. Or maybe we don't in this one, I don't know. Oh, yeah, there we go. And that's infielder Alex. And he's gonna go open up with a Pansier. So, it's quite a good thing we've got Baby Jaws up front. And well, Baby Jaws is actually still paralyzed, so... Seriously, Baby Jaws? Seriously? Okay, so... Will that take us out? Okay, so Baby Jaws is dead. So, god damn it, Baby Jaws. See, this is I'm just sitting raging to myself. Ignore me, guys. But this is why I don't think taking on the gym right now would be a great idea. as I'm still a bit underleveled, so I'll probably just finish off doing these kind of areas just now. Oh jeez, now you're asleep. Thunder, you're really... between you and Baby Jaws. Okay, so this isn't actually going well. This is just a fucking pantsier. But, Morphs too. I don't even know really why I'm using you. I just kinda decided to send you out. And okay, you have 1 HP left. But at least you didn't die. Because that could have been bad. That would have been 3 for 3. And so it's all really up to Bugsy and in Firebacon, so. There you go, Panpour, sit down. Sit down. And Pansage is coming next, and I'm just gonna stay over Bugsy. And I think I'm gonna bug bite you. There you go, Pansage, that's the end of you. But you do get a good bit of money for it, so... you give me a potion. You give me a potion. Seriously. Okay, that's cool. I'm gonna switch Firebacon up front, and hopefully we'll just be able to KO these guys now. And Tranquil. Level 25. That thing's, but yeah, you can see why now I need to train a little bit, because I am... oh shit. I just forgot I'm fighting type. But yeah, now you can see why I need to train a little bit, because my team is, relatively under-leveled. Come on, Tranquil. You're going down. You're gonna use Roost. Are you serious? I hate it when Pokemon just prevent themselves from dying. It's like... especially when it's like, you know, especially when they know they're gonna die. Although I think this will act... what? Bullshit! Oh, great. Morphs. Gotta take this for the team. And Thunder 072. I'm gonna get revived. Just quick attack me, that's just insulting. Thunder 072. I really hope you can live. I hope you're faster. And you are. I'm happy with you now. And we're gonna get to level 24 as well, so... Sandile, we can easily counter with Bugsy. And we can just Razor Leaf this guy, and hopefully this should be the end of him. And there goes Sandile. There goes the infielder. And he's gonna give you a potion, to be honest. But it's okay. It's okay. It's all good. We've got this, it's fine, come on, we can do this. One more hit. Come on, survive, Bugsy. God damn it, please. For the sake of us, I do not want to die just to a random infielder. There we go. And there we go, that's all the infielders gone. And we're gonna leave now. And run all the way to the Pokemon Center crying, saying we need to heal. Because that place actually did give us quite a hammering, to be honest. Although it's kind of made it clear that I will need to train for the gym. Which is always good, so I reckon I'll be doing all the training next episode or off screen. Just because I reckon I will need to do quite a bit just to kind of bring myself up to scratch. And there we go. Although in this episode still we are gonna carry on to the right. As I believe there's still a couple of trainers down here we can fight, and a couple of items. I think this guy will give you the Macho Brace, which will actually increase your EVs, but it will also make your Pokemon slower in the meantime. And I'm gonna move... Yeah, actually, no, Fire Bacon up front's quite good. And what's this guy saying to it? This is called the Battle Train All Aboard. We're not even on a train. This doesn't make sense. Why are we on a battle train? This isn't a train. Your logic makes no sense. We're gonna arm thrust this Drillbur. Critical hit. And flame charge it to finish. And that should give us a speed boost as well, so that's always nice. Sorry, Hank, but you know, you weren't good enough. Come back here, cyclist. You know, no, yes, got you. I always hate it when the cyclists or the joggers or that just run away from you. You just look like a muppet running around chasing them. It's like, can they not see you behind? Can they not see you running behind them trying to battle them? And Fire Bacon is actually going to get switched out into Thunder. As long as this doesn't kill it. Yep, it's good. Oh, and that was a critical as well, so. And it's going to detect. I bet you has Roost as well, just like that other one does. Detect and Roost, detect and Roost. That would be the most annoying combination ever. Should see if it uses Roost now. It wouldn't even make a difference because it's dead. Sorry, Tranquil, good game. Flame Bacon has grown to 26. And Hector's gonna cry and change his tires. Okay, tomorrow I'll be on a home run. Backers, Stu, and Art. Okay, so this is gonna be double Scraggy. And that's that fighting type I was saying earlier on in this episode that if you want to get, go ahead. Really awesome Pokemon. I'll bug bite that out of a Scraggy. And flame charging it. Well, in Fire Bacon, you've not let me down. And Bugsy's gonna grow up a level as well, sweet. And he's gonna use Payback in it. Yeah, it didn't really do much. But Scraggy, good game, good game. Sorry I had to kill you, But, you know, it was, it had to be done, had to be done. And if you go further around, there's one more trainer down here. Yep, come here, come here. So you're gonna go up. No, no, see, but one trainer that doesn't decide to change path. It's a cyclist. And it's a Whirlipede. I'm just gonna flame charge it, and I think it'll take it out. Seriously? Seriously? Ah. Okay, we're gonna flame charge it. We're gonna go. It's gonna... Ah. Oh, take a two-hit KO. Oh my god, stop using Protect. Okay, this time for sure you're going down. And there we go. Fire Bacon's gonna get a decent amount of XP. And, yeah. We're all really happy now. And where's my Mr. Slave when I need him? Oh, I do think I dumped him in the PC because I didn't actually want to carry him about. And now that I actually... There's a tree there that needs cut and Mr. Slave's not with us. Super fan. Oh. Gonna arm thrust this, hopefully get it 4. Nope, 3. I don't actually think it's hit more than 3 times, despite the amount that I've used it. And Fire Bacon's now 27. Bacon. Now if you say bacon in a Jamaican accent, it sounds like an English person saying bacon. 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 Or going past a beer can. Bacon in a Jamaican accent sounds like an English person saying, pass the beer can. The beer can. Going past the beer can. Oh, yeah. I don't know. And, yeah, okay, so Fire Bacon's gonna pretty much be dead if he stays out. Actually, you know, I'm just gonna weaken it a little bit, just to kinda... I'm expecting him to die, I just kinda want him to kinda weaken it a little bit for... Oh! Or weaken it quite a hell of a lot. Yeah, there we go. And, who shall I want to get XP? Baby Jaws. I'm gonna give it to Thunder, just cause Baby Jaws will get a lot of experience in the gym. He's gonna use Detect and just prolong the inedible. Inevitable. Come on, Shockwave. There we go, level 25. Awesome. Only 5 more levels till he evolves. And... Yeah, I'm gonna let Light, I'm gonna let Baby Jaws take out Leopard. And this is, now that I've said that, Baby Jaws is no doubt gonna get killed. And... Oh, I flinched and couldn't move. See, if I'm not allowed to use Dig now, I will... Oh, that's fine, I didn't actually... No, wait. Because of Torment, can I actually hit with Dig next turn? I can't remember. Yeah, I can. That would be... That would actually be... Oh, that would be some amount of bull. Can't use Dig twice, okay. Just gonna have to go with Assurance then. Come on, Baby Jaws, we have got this. one more hit from Baby Jaws and you're going down. I can't use it twice, god damn it. It's not even annoying, it's just, you forget that it's up, and then it's just kinda, you forget that it's used, Torment, and then you just sit and try and use the same move. Either way, Baby Jaws will probably level up. Oh! So close. But yet so far. Oh, wild Pokemon. And I'll probably get a Repel up, and then we'll finish going around this corner. Where's my Repel? And I actually need to buy some more Repels, so... Where are we? Okay, I never actually realized this is a big area again. What's this guy doing? And he's gonna give you Snarl. Wait, what? Oh, he's gonna... Oh, what a bitch. Come back here. Oh, well. We'll get him later. But on that note, guys, we're gonna end up this stream here. If you've enjoyed it, don't forget to follow. If you're watching it on Twitch, if you're watching it on YouTube, and if you enjoyed it, don't forget to like, comment, rate, subscribe, and share. So until the next episode, guys, I will see you all later.